realize, of course, that suppression of evidence can be a criminal offense.
Thanks, sir, my lord.
Very well. Yes, Mr. Darren?
Sir, the Lord Manson, despite the evidence of this diary, which yesterday was lost, but today has been found, you know its contents.
Well, I suppose...
You wrote it, didn't you?
Yes.
It throws a very ugly light on your evidence of yesterday, doesn't it?
My dear Mr. Darren, do you expect...
I shouldn't advise you, sir, to ask me what I expect, or I might tell you. Just answer the question. Do you still tell us that your evidence is true?
Not exactly.
Not exactly. You now admit that the evidence you gave on oath is not exactly true. In other words, it is false.
My lord, before re-examining, I desire to call to your lordship's notice...
Mr. Beavis, I'm afraid I must deny myself the pleasure of hearing it until tomorrow morning at 8:30.
As your lordship please.
Member of the jury, kindly be in your places tomorrow at 10:30 a.m.
Another sensation for the chief newspapers, Darren.
I'm afraid I never read the chief newspapers.
No good leading against you, Darren. You have the devil's own luck.
No. No, weak witness.
He broke your man down.
The improper question. I'd have stopped him if I'd been Lord Chief.
The old man was as pleased as Punch. You almost forgot to bite his nails.
Well, I suppose we shall soon be bowing in court to Mr. Justice Darrant.
I thought you were in the running for that, Beavis.
Well, wouldn't have it, too much loss of income. No, Darrant here would prefer the dignity, even if he had my income.
Might prefer to enjoy both.
Oh, by the way, Darrant, I saw your young brother yesterday.
Oh, yes?
He's back from Kenya, isn't he?
No, Rhodesia.
Do well, then?
The crop failed. Larry's crops always fail. Good night.
Good night. That fellow's young brother must be a thorn in the flesh.
Oh, Larry! Have you been waiting long?
33 years, 5 months. I can't remember the days, hours and minutes, darling.
Oh, I love you when you are silly.
That means for life, but do you love me when I'm broke?
Oh, poor Larry, nothing left out of your allowance.
4 whole pennies, all it takes. Poor old Keith, in the running for the bench and settled with a brother who backs nothing but losers.
Oh, darling, you do have rotten luck. You never will.
Now, if I knew, though.
Hey! What's your pipe in old fellow?
Salam, Alex! Oh, look there. You can't beat old McPherson. There's something for every occasion. Close your eyes and take a choice.
A funeral?
There's the urn for grandfather's ashes.
And a marriage?
Oh, everything for a marriage.
You will never want to marry.
I don't know. I could certainly do with a wedding breakfast just now. Couldn't you?
No, but food for tonight.
Yeah, poor darling. You only gave me a bob on this last time, and it's seen service since.
There is this.
I can't pop this icon.
Just for the week, Larry. I give it you. It is yours. Please, Larry.
Five bob, you old scoundrel. Come on now, Tony's quick. Let's get to your place before the fun gets any worse.
Good evening, sir.
Hello, how are you?
How's tonight?
That's all he knows.
Good evening, miss. Good luck, miss.
Hiya, Pat.
Good luck.
Thank you, we've got it.
Ah, there, we're rich.
Hello, Tony.
Ha ha, sit down with me, vecchi amici, eh?
They're finer than ever.
Sì, di fatti, sono belli i miei baffi. E mi fanno ricordare dei bei tempi antichi. Vanda, you are late tonight. I thought you weren't coming.
We've got 5 bob out of old McPherson, and we're going to celebrate.
Celebrating? But you've done nothing else for the last 6 weeks,
you know. That's just what we're celebrating.
Well, benissimo. Then you have just what you want for the occasion. Here we have fagioli as sweet as honey, salsicce, salami, mortadella, and here we have ravioli alla bolognese. Beautiful, squisiti, raffinati e deliziosi.
Ah, ravioli, eh, Wanda?
Yes.
And some sandwiches?
Suppongo che vogliono avere some chianti.
No, half a flask, please, Tony. It's been a bad day.
Come bello. Ecco, alla vostra salute. Di tanti auguri.
Thank you, sir.
Good night, sir. Buonasera, sì.
See you tomorrow.
Don't go under there, Larry.
Oh, come on.
Your luck is my luck, Larry.
Do they have that superstition in Russia, too? What's wrong?
The light. Someone's in my room.
Nonsense. You left it on this morning. The door's locked, isn't it?
No, I lost the key last week.
Well, someone's been in to tidy up, that's all.
Good evening, Paragaya. I've come home.
Who are you?
Better ask my wife.
I got the excursion boat from Boulogne. Saves a passport.
I say to myself, I look up wonder. It must be 3 years since I saw my wife. A man needs a home sometimes. I say to myself, perhaps she has some money now. In my country, a wife works for her husband. Don't think I'm angry with you. A girl needs company sometimes. If I hadn't married her 3 years ago, she'd have starved. But it didn't look well when she ran away. Everything can be arranged. I always say a man's got to pay for his pleasure, eh? What do you say? Huh? £20. Too much, hmm? Say 10, then. Now, no violence. All we've got to do is talk. Just talk. Everything can be arranged.
Keep back! Get out, you filthy
snake! Get out, you little nut! Not murder, Larry. He was bad. We will forget he was ever here. God will not let us suffer. Everything will be as it was before.
Put the note down there, Barnes. What the? Larry? What do you want? Oh, come and sit down. What's the matter? Pull yourself together and sit down.
is it?
I've killed a man.
What do you mean, a motoring accident?
It's true. I've killed a man.
Yes, what is it?
I locked it, Keith.
All right, put them down outside, will you? Why come and tell me this?
Whom else should I tell? You know about these things. Shall I give myself up, Keith? Must I? I'll go now, if you say so.
No. Mustn't do anything in a hurry. You better tell me all about it.
It's like this. There's a girl.
It would be a woman.
We went back to her rooms this evening. Her husband was there. A brute named Wallen.
One of those stories.
No, it's not like that, Keith. She hasn't seen him for 3 years. He turned up tonight. He thought he could get money from her. Well, he went for me. I got him by the throat. And when I let go...
Yes?
Dead.
Well, what did you do then?
Well, we sat by it for a long time. And then I carried it to an archway at the end of the street.
Did anyone see you?
No.
What time was this?
About an hour ago.
And then?
Then I went back to her.
Why?
She was lonely and afraid. So was I, Keith.
Did you take anything off the body?
Yes. This.
Put it in the fire. No, why should I be your accomplice? Now, try and think clearly if you know how. This girl, would she give you away?
Never.
Would she give herself away, hysteria?
No.
Did you have anything of hers?
Nothing.
At your room?
Nothing. A picture.
Well, burn it. Any letters?
No.
Presents?
No.
How drunk were you?
I wasn't drunk.
You say you didn't mean to kill him.
Of course not.
Oh, well, that's something. What made you choose the archway?
It's the first dark place.
Did his face look as if he'd been strangled? Did it?
Yes.